Backstage before the 2001 Challenge Cup final, Sheffield Steelers chasing UK ice hockey's Grand Slam of the four major titles. They've already got two in the bag, and tonight on Four Later, they're just one match away from grabbing a third. Standing between Sheffield and glory are the Ayr Scottish Eagles, the only team in Super League history with a Grand Slam to their name. Welcome to UK Ice Hockey on Four Later. It's very exciting tonight. We're at the final of the Challenge Cup here in the Odyssey Arena in Belfast. It should be an amazing game between the Ayr Scottish Eagles and the Sheffield Steelers. You can hear the crowd behind me going absolutely nuts. We've got fans of both sides with us here, and we're going to show you how those sides got to the final. The Eagles' glory year was back in 1998, a team led by head coach Jim Lynch sweeping all the major trophies in only the second season in the ISL Super League's short life. Four players at the heart of that Grand Slam success are still with them.
Here we won all the cups. It was unbelievable. There was a real Scottish mood about the air. You know, they had the flags in the stands and they sang the Scottish national anthem before all the games, and you almost felt like honorary Scotsman at times. It was fun.
We're an older team. We've got a few older guys, obviously, and a few younger guys, so we've sort of been in finals before, but we're not relaxed that we're not taking the game that serious. We're desperate to win the game.
Ayr fought their way past London Knights in their semi-final with a nail-biting victory in the capital after being held to a 10-goal tie at their home rink. Both legs of that semi-final showed Ayr's strengths and weaknesses, fast and exciting in front of goal, sometimes suspect at the back.
I don't know who your nails are, but I'm doing it at the bone myself. It'd be nice if that'd be a real luxury and a real bonus if we could get a 4-goal spread or something. We're obviously wanting to try and get the puck deep in there and try and create offense, but play well defensively at the same time. So a lot can depend on breaks and luck as well, you know. So I would imagine it's going to be a tight hockey game and probably one or two goal spread in it.
Super League champion Sheffield are busy proving that they have no weaknesses in their lineup. An awesome 7-0 drubbing of the Belfast Giants in the second leg of their semi showed they have no peers in the British game when they are on song. But with all sorts of financial worries surrounding the club's future going into this match, the big question is, how will it affect their game?
Had a few off-ice difficulties lately, but I think they've washed that aside, and the minds are clear and ready to go win a hockey game. That's one thing about our team. Even with off-ice difficulties at times, they've been able to focus on the actual hockey. When the puck is dropped, they've been very good.
Once you win the league, you sort of take your foot off the pedal a bit. So over the last 3 weeks, we've not really had anything to play for, and the fans have been giving us a little bit stick at some of the games. So tonight's a time to turn that around.
It's a packed house here tonight, even though the Giants aren't playing. Ayr and Sheffield supporters having made the trip across the Irish Sea in their droves.
It's great, and I think a lot of the Belfast fans will be supporting us as well, so hopefully it'll be like playing at home.
We were drawn as the road team on the coin toss, so we're thinking of this as a road game. We just beat Belfast Giants in here with all their fans cheering for them, so I can't imagine it'll be any louder than that. So I think, we're probably going to be they're certainly going to be the people's choice, let's put it that way.
Well, here we are in the Odyssey Arena then, and what a magnificent scene it is. What a great setting for this Challenge Cup final. Packed to the rafters, fans of the Steelers, fans of the Eagles, neutrals here for a great game of hockey, which is, I'm sure, what we're going to see this evening. Seth Bennett, what are we going to expect?
Well, I think it's going to be a huge game this evening. Both teams have come in some great form, and you've got a classic encounter tonight. You've got all the offense of the Ayr Scottish Eagles, and you've got the Sheffield Steelers, the way they play team hockey. their commitment to team defence. I think this evening, I think the key players are going to be Ed Courtney for the Air Scottish Eagles, along with Teda Wynn and Tony Hand. I think those three players, particularly if Paul Heavey plays them together like he has done, they're going to provide a lot of offence, and they really need to get to the Steelers early.
First goal, very important, isn't it?
It's going to be the key, particularly with the crowd, with around 5,000 Belfast fans here, as well as Eagles and Steelers fans. That could sway which side the neutrals fall on, and I think the crowd support is going to make a big difference.
It's going to be huge. It's going to be here on UK Ice Hockey. Make sure you stick with us. What a game we've got coming up. What an atmosphere.
Let's have a chat with some of our punters. So you're clearly, look at all your badges. You've got to be a very big fan in the Steelers. How many matches have you seen this season?
Matches?
Yeah.
Nearly every one. Apart from a couple of away ones.
So now, who's going to win then?
Obvious.
You're obviously very biased, but who's your best players in the game tonight going to be?
Oneg. No, Oneg.
And Courtney, we've got a rival at the back here. Now you cannot be a Steelers fan. Look at Yorkie.
No, definitely not. I must admit, Steelers and Eagles are on great together. Fans are superb with each other.
Yes.
We always have them.
Will you be reacting in quite the same way at the end of the game?
Yes, because we're going for a beer afterwards, no matter what.
And I'm sure a few of the players will as well. So is this the best team ever assembled in British ice hockey? Fast becoming an orthodoxy to think so about the Sheffield Steelers. They're looking to eclipse the Air Scottish Eagles' proud Grand Slam record of 1998.
Starting lineup for the Eagles then, Scott Young and Jan Mikkel are the two defencemen. Rhett Gordon, Mark Montanari and Teda Wynn are the others in the starting lineup. Coach Paul Heavey's reunited Tony Hand and Ed Courtney though. Two really big keys for the Air Scottish Eagles.
Well, key for the Sheffield Steelers last week was Scott Allison. He's missing, his band's back on again today.
And the Steelers' starting lineup will be Shane McCosh and Cale Short, two defensemen that have done so well for the Steelers this year. Up front, they've got Dale Craigwell with Kent Simpson and Jason Weaver. Another person that's missing from the Sheffield Steelers' lineup is Paul Lady. He's still suffering from a groin problem.
The referee is Murray Hansen. He's not loved in Ayr or Sheffield by the fans, but then that's often the way of it for referees, isn't it? He'll be the one taking control in this cauldron of an atmosphere here at the Odyssey Arena in Belfast. Craigwell and Montanari to contest the opening face-off of the 2001 Challenge Cup Final. Arms in the air and we are underway. The opening win goes to the Ayr Scottish Eagles, who straight away play it down the left-hand side. That'll be McCosh behind his own net, and he'll instantly go on a charge up the ice. He's seen some space in front of him. He loves to lead the rush to Shane McCosh from defence. Fights his way through. The shot comes off, and that's Simpson snapping one in on Philip de Rouville, who turns it away very quickly indeed. And the first early chance, Seth, for the Sheffield Steelers.
Intentions definitely clear. Steelers defenceman Shane McCosh jumping up into the play, getting that early chance, and de Rouville just kicking him away. Steelers not quite able to capitalise.
That's a whistle for offside. What about the way Simpson took the shot? Because he didn't have much time, did he?
He was also getting the help back by the defenceman, so he just tried to put it on net, and that's something that Mike Blaisdell, the coach of the Sheffield Steelers, will be really pressing into his players.
Face-off then, just outside Steelers territory. It's the Ayr Scottish Eagles in the orange and white, going from right to left. Round the boards it goes now, held in by Ed Courtney, forced out towards the blue line. Steelers try and get it clear. Ed Courtney flips it forward though, and they circle it to the Ayr Scottish Eagles. Courtney still waits. We won't get the pass though, because the Steelers have stripped it away, bounced it off the boards, and Longstaff can pick up. Under pressure all the time though, the Eagles making the Steelers work inside their own zone. Sebastian gets rid of it now, and Longstaff should be able to get it out towards Brabant, right hand side. Brabant feeds it in, looking for the stretch of Longstaff, not able to get to him. And the Ayr Scottish Eagles really going after the Steelers.
They have, they've come out and they've made their own intentions clear, which is, doesn't matter who's out there, they're going to make sure they take the body in the Steelers zone and force the Steelers good skating defensemen like McCosh and like Sebastian, that they're going to have to play the puck early, and the Steelers are going to have to work hard in their own zone.
Here goes Longstaff now for the Sheffield Steelers. Tried to lay it in on the backhand towards Rick Brabant. The pass was stopped, and Brabant is in there in the corner to try and dig it out. Whistle will go because Doyle and Longstaff between them were holding the puck against the boards.
Newcastle-born David Longstaff, the fans' favourite and top point scorer for Sheffield this season, with 19 goals and 29 assists. In fact, both teams boast potent offensive lines, the Eagles' Tony Hand having the second best set of stats in the league.
The fans have certainly taken their cue from the players here at the Odyssey. The atmosphere is intense, I think is the best way to describe it. Good face-off win for Rick Brabant for the Steelers. Comes out towards the near side, flipped inside by Hand. No one could get on the end of that. That's Hillstrom picking up, feeding it towards Courtney. Courtney for the Air Scottish Eagles with the opening goal, and that could be oh so important in their attempt to dent the Sheffield Steelers' Grand Slam hopes and win this Challenge Cup.
Well, that's the genius of Ed Courtney, willing to shoot from anywhere, and Hillstrom pinches in the defence with Feason inside. He's behind the goal line, he fires it, tries to go near side, and eventually I think that takes a kick off the skate of the defenceman Steve Carpenter and goes in. Another chance to have a look. Courtney picks it up here, he just spins around, fires that. I think it just rebounds off the skate of Steve Carpenter and into the back of that net. And the Air Scottish Eagles, what a start for them.
Absolutely. Put the puck on the net, you might just get the goal.
Just the start that Air had been looking for. And they almost went two ahead a couple of minutes later when Sean Byram was put through on goal but fired the shot straight at Mike O'Neill. End-to-end hockey at the Odyssey Arena. We rejoin the match with the Eagles still holding that one goal lead.
Norris and Byram to contest this one. Byram is so good at face-offs and he's won yet another one. Gets it back to Doyle. Puts it round the back of the boards, or tried to, but he's under pressure. And now the Air Scottish Eagles should get rid of it. They have a bit of a struggle on and then finally get it out towards this right-hand side. That's Bauba. Nice stop from Bauba. Couldn't quite keep hold of the puck. Dennis Vial's lost out again, but he fights for it and manages to clear it up into the zone. Flip forward on the backhand. Here come the Steelers now. Vial's inside. If they can find him with Metcalf. Metcalf's passed just under Vial's stick. Forced to feed it back to the point. Still the Steelers have it in the zone and it's turned away. They picked it up again though. This is good work. Vial snaps the shot. Turned away by DeRouville and Metcalf couldn't quite finish that at the far post.
Interesting line thrown together by the Steelers coach Mike Blaisdell. He's got Dennis Vial playing as a forward, usually a defenseman, but in the absence of Paul Adey and Scott Allison, he's thrown this line together and they're using a lot of checking potential on the boards at the moment.
That was Smith carrying the puck forward. Metcalf will pursue it into the corner. Montanari has got there though. Little slash at the back of Metcalf. Montanari can be a little bit chippy like that.
Two really intense characters actually, Scott Metcalf and Mark Montanari. So you get a chance to just see this again. The shot from Dennis Vial fired in. Great kick save actually by DeRouville, just kicking it right into the corner.
DeRouville has had an outstanding Challenge Cup. His statistics are far, far better in this competition than they are in the league as a whole. Goals against average of just 2.66. Really very good indeed. Behind his own net now is Short. Carries it away and looks to flip it out on the left-hand side. Good cross-ice pass there. The chase is on from Craig. Well, he can't pick it up. Eagles get the chance to push it down the right wing. Nice work from Short. Good defensive play and should clear it now. Steelers just settle things down behind their own net. Out towards the right-hand side. Just pushing forward and looking to make the Eagles work. And they're going to do so now. Round the back of the net now goes Simpson. Simpson trying to flip it out in front. No passing lanes for him. Fired in now. Deflected nearly in on net. And just taken away by DeRouville there.
Yeah, Scottish Eagles sending two men actually down in with Simpson into the corner, and the Steelers nearly managed to capitalise by throwing the puck back out in front, but there was no defenceman around.
Carpenter touches up for the icing for the Sheffield Steelers. Chance to relieve some of the pressure. Great game so far.
It has. It's been a really high-octane start for both sides. The Eagles definitely signalling how they want to come out, hitting hard. So we're just going to get another chance to see on the replay here. Carpenter just firing this one in. There's a chance out in front, but it just breaks out into the corner. I think DeRouville just got a piece of that, actually.
Well, Carpenter doesn't get many from his defensive positions. Only four goals so far this season. Rick Brabant against Tony Hand in that face-off. Hand won it. So important to do that inside your own zone when you're defending. The Steelers have got the puck back. Eagles nearly get the chance to clear. Beraldo forces it back in. Longstaff goes after it. Brabant is in there as well. Brabant holding it against the boards, gets it towards Longstaff. Good work by Longstaff to pick that up on the boards. He should be able to push this back out towards the point. Unfortunate kickoff escape. And McCosh tries to hold it in. He can't. Here's Courtney now. Passes it to Harding. That's a lovely feed. Harding's one-on-one for a moment. Harding gets the shot away. That was going wide anyway, I think, even before Mike O'Neill got to it. Steelers now moving towards the other end. Smith trying to get the pass. Intercepted in neutral ice. Eagles keeping the pressure on with Hand. Hand dropping it off just behind him. Circling gets the puck back now. Harding's with him. Harding tries to hold it in. Breakout on for the Sheffield Steelers with Longstaff. End-to-end stuff this. Longstaff holds it in. Fires it round the boards because the Steelers are going to take the chance for a line change.
Oh, and what a quick game this has been so far. It's been absolutely end-to-end and both sides really are putting everything in the early stages because they realise just how key it is.
Sebastian trying to dig that out of there. Norris is in there as well as they try and get it off the boards. They've done so, the Sheffield Steelers. And at the moment, it's the Steelers looking a little more fluent in attack as they go down the right-hand side with Norris. Norris looking to go round the back of the net. Norris feeds it back with shot taken in the back of the net. The lights on. Carpenter, that was his fifth goal of the season from the point on the feed from Norris. He lashed that home. I didn't see it, so I don't see how DeRouville could have done.
Warren Norris with all the speed, he burst all the way into the zone, round the back of the net, just laid it off, and then it's fired in. But even on the replay, It's so difficult to catch a hold of the puck because he just hits it so hard. An absolute bullet went all the way through Deruval. Really didn't have a chance, to be honest.
What's that, 100 miles an hour from about 30 feet? Watch it, shot. The next thing you see is the net bulging. That's the only thing you see in between. You just can't tell. And Carpenter, with his fifth goal, levels it up for the Sheffield Steelers. And that's a momentum shifter, perhaps.
It definitely could be. The Air Scottish Eagles, though, have come out and they've played so well in the early stages, looking to take the body, playing fairly tight defensively as well. It's really the first proper chance the Sheffield Steelers have had, except for that Dennis Miao shot. And so, you know, the Eagles are going to look to just keep it tight at this point.
Mike Blaisdell on the Sheffield bench showing just how much that first goal meant to him. The Steelers' Grand Slam dream back on track. We move the action on a couple of minutes. Back to Seth and Colin. Inside Steelers' territory, won by the defending team. And Short puts it round behind the net as Steelers look to clear their lines. Flipped up into neutralised. Bauber tried to glove that down. It sent Norris away. Norris just flipping it in, turned away by Deruville. And he'll get it back now in the corner. Norris flipping it behind him, round the boards on the backhand. Vial on the chase there. Metcalf there as well. Neither of them can hold it in the zone. And out it goes into Steelers' territory.
Trevor Doyle just doing his job, just getting in on the boards, and Dennis Vial surprisingly not making contact on big Trevor Doyle. Doyle just giving the time to just flick it down length of the ice.
This is Norris once again. Norris driving the shot. Deruville pushes it out to his right where Montanari can mop up. And Montanari still has it. He's got options inside, but not many now as they go on the line change. But still Montanari goes. He might look to put it behind him. He did. He dropped it off there. But Rhett Gordon couldn't get there ahead of the defence.
Montanari then just kept his feet moving the whole shift, picked it up in his own zone. He didn't look down at the puck once. He just kept skating, his feet kept moving, and the Steelers defenseman really struggled to get a hold of him, and eventually they did manage to get him, but only behind the back of the net.
In neutral ice once again, where it's gloved down by the Sheffield Steelers. They're having the more sustained pressure now. Air seemed to have let up on some aspects of the physical game as this first period's gone on. They were laying the body on early, and they've stopped doing that quite so much now. Weaver, right-hand side, forced to hold it up now. He pushes it into the corner. Chase is on. Air should clear. Round the boards and do. And for all the pressure, not a huge number of shots in this particular spell.
Not from the high percentage shooting areas for the Steelers. What they want to do is they want to try and shoot from the area right in between the two face-off circles. And they're not getting those chances. They're just throwing the puck on net, just hoping for anything to come out.
And that's McCosh behind his own net. We've talked about his love of going forward. He's having something of a career year, points-wise. Pass it out towards his right-hand side now. This is Beraldo. Beraldo taking the shot from the difficult angle. Deruville's well out of his net. Beraldo has it. Tried to force it into a position where they could take the shot. The Steelers couldn't do so, and it's back into that corner. Picked up again. Fed inside. Eagles should clear. This is Harding on the puck, and he'll just calm things down for the Air Scottish Eagles. Flipping it forward on the backhand into neutral ice. Looking for the long pass on the stretch. Not quite getting it. Whistle goes for offside.
Yeah, the Air Scottish Eagles really have to think about what they're doing now. They've just been lured onto the back foot, and I think we're going to get a chance to see the Sheffield Steelers flying through with Warren Norris. He's looking to just cut back to the inside and just flick it in on net, and Deruville is just turning those away. He's not going to have problems with those kind of shots, you would have thought.
Face-off will come in neutral ice now. It's one apiece, remember. Couldn't be tenser. The atmosphere couldn't be better inside the Odyssey. Both sets of fans and the neutrals as well are well into this game. It's been lively, it's been fast, and it's been end-to-end stuff. Carpenter, scorer of the Steelers' goal, flips it out towards neutral ice. Norris will chase that. He won't get there. Eagles just clear it back. And at the moment, from neutral ice, the Eagles are just kind of flipping it into the Steelers' zone.
That's right, and the Air Scottish Eagles are only sending really one forechecker in. That's the forward, like Sean Byram there, putting pressure on the defenceman. And all that means is the Steelers' defenceman are having that much extra time to clear the puck out.
That was Bauber's nice stick work inside the neutral zone, but when he flipped it to his right, Byram was to his left, so there was no connection. Here come the Steelers once again, trying to force the game. Flipped into the corner now. Eberle comfortable to pick that up, and Metcalf's brought him down. Norris is all alone. He's got the pass from Vial, pulls it inside and pulls the dink, scores! Norris all alone, and it was a lovely move to Fox Deruville and to score the goal, and it's a goal from nothing to send the Steelers in front.
Hard work in the corner and a nice pass by Dennis Vial. Just gets it out in front. We saw him go from forehand to backhand last week. Today it's backhand to forehand, and Deruville had no chance on the little move out in front. But what hard work from Metcalf to just knock the puck loose, and then Vial, no look pass right out in front to Norris. And Norris, oh well, he deked him right out of his pads, didn't he?
Excellent work from Warren Norris.
And he's been absolutely inspired in the last 10 minutes or so.
Warren Norris giving the Steelers the lead a couple of minutes before the end of the period. After that, Mike O'Neill was again in action in the Sheffield goal, this time standing up to Ayres' fast-skating Mike Harding. But no luck for the Eagles. Sheffield ending the first period having fought their way back after Ed Courtney's goal in the opening moments.
OK, well, it's 2-1 here after the first period. It's been fiercely contested. The Steelers are ahead, but Air Scottish Eagles are giving it their all. Come and join us later after the break.
Welcome back to our coverage of the Challenge Cup final from Belfast. Sheffield beating the Air Scottish Eagles 2-1 after the first period. This is another view of Sheffield's second goal, and if you want to join in the Steelers celebrations at home, here's what to do when they notch a score.
Wash it behind you!
Come on, sing along, folks! We are number one! We are number one! Yay!
Well, those fans have had the chance to exercise their tonsils on a much parodied tune around the league twice so far in this Challenge Cup final. The Eagles fans celebrating just the once, but as even a game as you could hope to see.
Well, the Eagles will want to come out hard in this second period, like they did in the first period. They need to get back into the game, because if the Steelers continue to lead the game, they'll try and put it to bed as it goes on. But the Eagles, they'll want to score early.
Flipped in by the Eagles, behind the goal line is McCosh. Carrying it forward again, he does that so often, just looks up the ice, looks for the rush, and then plays it out to his left-hand side. That's Weaver, forced across into neutral ice. Weaver still gets the shot away, though. It went wide. Craigwell to pick it up in the corner and get the feed again behind the net. Weaver tussles for it, it goes through him and out towards that far side. Short pushes it forward on the backhand. They're holding it in the zone. Weaver calls for help from Craigwell. Montanari's there, held against the board's face-off.
That's what the Eagles have to do. They have to get with the Steelers in their own zone.
Air still pressing for an equaliser, but look at this statistic from the first period. The Steelers outshooting the Eagles by 11-3, but just that one goal up. They've got another chance now as we return to the action on an Eagles power play.
One of those frustrating penalties, too many men on the ice. As a coach, you really don't want to take those.
Well, it's a great opportunity for the Air Scottish Eagles, though. You've got to look at it from their perspective. And although Blaisdell for the Steelers will be upset, the Air Scottish Eagles are just going to look to use the likes of your Tony Hands and your Ed Courtney's to get themselves back into this game and tie it up at two.
And they're pushing forward now down this right-hand side, ringed straight around the boards, forcing O'Neill out of his net to stop it. O'Neill under pressure as he flips it around. Eagles just happy to hold it in the zone. Flip it forward on the backhand now. Round the back of the net it goes, and Gordon picks it up. Gordon with a feed out towards the point. This is Swilfer-Platt. Swilfer-Platt puts it down low. He's going to look to get the puck back now, but it's pushed out past him and back into Eagles territory.
Eagles kept on the outside then by the Steelers defensemen and forwards. They just made sure they couldn't get to the inside and get that high percentage shooting area that we've already talked about.
Eagles there tried for the quick release into the zone. They didn't make it work. Mikkel tries to feed it inside now. Interception in neutralised by the Steelers, who'll kill some time inside their own territory.
The other thing you have to remember is the fact that the Steelers are short-benched, and so they don't need to take any time with less men than they have to.
Well, that's Weaver on the chase. Now, Weaver's still got the puck. He takes it around, nearly scores the short-handed goal. Deruville down smartly at his near post.
Lax defending by the defenceman, you've got to say there, allowing Jason Weaver, although he's so big and strong, but they allowed him just to walk around the net and shoot on goal. Nice save, Deruville.
And still, they kill time, the Sheffield Steelers. Still, they have the puck. The Eagles will be desperate to get this back and make the most of their power play. And Steelers at the moment just passing it around.
Fantastic penalty killing. All they're doing is they're looking up, they're finding a free man. And because Air aren't pressuring them, they've only sent that one man in again on the forecheck, the Steelers can just play it around amongst themselves.
Steelers there, that's a mistake and a turnover. They fed it through towards Courtney. Courtney now down the right-hand side, just drops it back towards the point. He'll look for it again towards the hash marks. Courtney taking it in down low, just dropping it off as they circle it. Tony Hand will just try and quarterback things from here now. Hand drives it in, gets it through O'Neill and into the back of the net. Don't know if O'Neill was screened there. It doesn't matter. The Eagles are level again, and it's that man, Tony Hand.
I think Mike O'Neill, the Steelers goalie, is just surprised by that. Tony Hand got the puck finally into the zone. He got the opportunity, and this is where he looks for the pass, but no, he just lets this bullet go, and it goes right in the far top corner. Lovely, lovely shot by him. A man that generally doesn't shoot the puck. You'd expect a pass here, but Tony Hand just fired this, and I think he just caught Mike O'Neill off guard.
Well, Tony Hand's got that reputation for liking to pass rather than score, but he's been belying that this season. That's his 20th goal out of 56 points now. That's the largest percentage of goals per point that he's ever had.
I think as well you've got to look at Tony Hand and you've got to see the fact that this has been his best year, and maybe it's because he's reunited with Ed Courtney, but the strange thing is they haven't played on the same line, and he's been energised into playing this great hockey where he's putting the puck on net and getting plenty of goals.
It's Metcalf putting the pressure off the Steelers, and he's forced the mistake as well. Vial tried to feed it in and Norris was there but couldn't turn it home.
This line hastily thrown together by the Sheffield Steelers, but that's the line that's caused all the problems so far offensively, and really they've done so well just to play the puck around.
Norris there trying to skate through his man, taken away from him by Young, who pushes it out on that left hand side and fed forward now into that corner where Teda Wynn can pick it up for the Eagles. He just kind of lost it under his stick there. Carpenter can clear, and away they come now down that left hand side. Metcalf dumps it towards the far corner as the Steelers maybe look for a line change. They're not going to get it. Air have pushed it straight back. That takes a deflection. That will give everyone a chance to change their personnel. Carpenter passing it up the ice there. That's been picked up by Simpson, who's way from him. That's just taken away from him at the last second as he tried to take the shot. Derouville's well out of his net. No one there to capitalise for the Steelers, who are putting the pressure on now. But Eagles have it inside their own territory. Mikkel should clear it. He's brought down as he does so, but he's still got it out towards that left-hand side. Young can skate away with it. Young forced to circle, but still keeps it in the zone. That's the crucial thing. Mikkel trying to feed it across and nearly gets it to Wynn. Wynn flips it through on net, takes a bounce off the side. Montanari couldn't hold it, but still the Eagles have it with Montanari now. Trying to keep it in that corner. Gordon's in there to dig it out as well. Gordon wrestling his way with Carpenter towards the blue line, and finally the Steelers get rid of it.
It's got really scrappy, hasn't it? Neither side really taking control of the puck, and somebody does need to just get a stick on it, calm it down, and then look to get the offense going.
And still the Steelers can't clear properly. They should do it now. It was Wynn trying to hold it in there and promote. The Steelers have a 3-on-2. Men back for the Eagles now to drive it in. Joni just deflected by Derouville.
Another strange angle shot, really, by the Sheffield Steelers. Just firing in from all different kinds of angles and sending men to the net just to see if they can get a hold of anything.
And that's forced out of the zone. Here comes Young again. Young skating away with it. He's got Gordon to his right. He chose to go left instead and just bounces it off the board to give the Eagles time to change their lines. McCosh trying to take advantage at the other end. McCosh racing through on net, wrestled down, and Eagles can clear now. That's good work from Wynn. He's found Hand on the left-hand side. Hand's got Courtney inside him. Courtney goes towards the net. Hand maybe shakes the shot, fires and scores! Tony Hand for the Air Scottish Eagles!
Hold on, I think, though. Murray Hansen's just spreading his arms wide. He's just been pushed out of the way as well. But I don't think this one's going to count. I think that Ed Courtney may have just got into the crease. He was actually knocked into the back of the net. Now, the Eagles are claiming that he got knocked into the back of the net by the Steelers defenseman. I think some of the fans are not too happy about it either.
Well, they're certainly expressing their anger. Let's take another look and see what we can see here.
Tony Hand in that same position again. There's Ed Courtney. He's in the crease. Jason Weaver goes sliding into him. The puck's in the back of the net. Courtney's in the back of the net. And unfortunately, that's not going to be a goal.
Now, let's just take you through the rule. The rule is, if the player's in the crease before the puck, it's no goal. Simple as that. So that's what we've got to watch for here.
And I think it is quite clear. Hand still has the puck. He fakes a shot. Courtney's in the crease now. Both feet are in. Hand then winds up. Courtney's in the back of the net. Tough call, but I think Hansen actually made the right decision on this occasion.
And crucial to Ayres' anger there is the fact that if Weaver had been the one to push Courtney into the crease first of all, the goal would have stood. The face-off is going to be in neutral territory as a result. Eagles will feel they should be leading by now. Our replays suggest otherwise. Into that corner it goes. Steelers now on a bit of a breakaway, skating it down this left-hand side. That's Longstaff. Longstaff looks up, takes the feed inside. That's Beraldo! Beraldo for the Sheffield Steelers! A goal that wasn't at one end, a goal that will stand at the other, and the Sheffield Steelers have taken the lead.
Well, what a momentum switcher that is. The Eagles couldn't manage it at one end. Longstaff brings it right back down the other end. And there's Paul Beraldo. Great traffic out in front by Jeff Sebastian. But that man, Paul Beraldo, has got a beautiful, beautiful shot. As we've already seen on UK ice hockey, and from this kind of distance, high percentage shooting area, he's just going to find nothing but twine.
Well, we taught you the tune earlier. If you're from South Yorkshire, you might like to join in with those Steelers fans.
So, within just 15 seconds of play, to the total disgust of the players and the fans, the Eagles had seen a goal disallowed and then conceded one at the other end. Referee Hansen's popularity north of the border plummeting to an all-time low. And then, having found the net twice from out there on the left wing, Tony Hand tried once more, this time O'Neill getting himself in front of the puck.
the Eagles' chance has improved again with a clearly unhappy Dennis Vial escorted off to the sin bin after this high-sticking incident. Another power play to air, but less than a minute left on the period 2 clock.
So the Steelers successfully killing off a chunk of this power play for the Eagles, but they had to concede a face-off inside their own territory. Won by Craigwell, into the corner, Short trying to kick it free for the Steelers, held in and passed across the zone by Swilferplatz, who'll wait on the point to get it back now. Feeds it in again, they're just going to pass it around in this formation now. Swilferplatz winds up for the shot, takes the deflection, Wynn, oh my, how did that go wide? Tina Wynn had a huge slice of net to aim at and something deflected that wide. But still, the Air Scottish Eagles keep it going, they've got a shot out in front now, but smothered by O'Neill in the end. Gets down low at the feet of Bristow.
Well, I think that Mike O'Neill got a bit of stick on this, because otherwise Tina Wynn would have had a half-empty net to fire the puck into. I think the boys in the truck are going to give us another chance to have a look as Silverplatz fires this one all the way in. Takes a little deflection there, right to Tina Wynn. Look at him, gets it right into his forehand side. I don't know, I think he may have just put that into the side netting. A little bit of interference from Kale Short's stick. Two former roommates, those guys. And then he takes him into the boards afterwards, but Tina Wynn will be very disappointed not to have put that one away.
Just carried wide by the defence and by O'Neill sprawling across. And the Steelers breathe again, still 3-2 ahead. Still short-handed as the Eagles keep it in the zone with Gordon, right-hand side. Gordon trying to feed it down low, bounces it off behind the net, wins out in front, takes a bounce off O'Neill. And Carpenter picks up the rebound as the hooter goes. The end of the second period, which has gone the way of the Sheffield Steelers on a controversial no goal against the Air Scottish Eagles.
Hockey, a huge game of momentum, and momentum swung, and this time it did swing in the favour of the Sheffield Steelers.
Both coaches with difficult team talks, a one goal lead, not easy to defend in hockey.
Well, what a tense period that was. It was 3-2 to the Sheffield Steelers. Air Scottish Eagles throwing everything at them at the end, but they just couldn't penetrate that defence. Join us after the break and see if they can get back into this match.
Welcome back. We're at the Odyssey Arena in Belfast for UK Ice Hockey's coverage of the Challenge Cup final. A great game so far.
Well, I've got a Sheffield fan with me now. Now, it's 3-2 to Sheffield. I've been sat behind you, and every time Sheffield score a goal, you're on the phone. What's going on there?
I've got to ring my wife at home. She's been working today, so I've got to keep her in touch. She can't listen to it on the radio. She gets too nervous, so you've got to keep her up to date with what's happening.
So how many games a season do you go to? Are you a regular fan?
Yeah, all the home games, as many of the away games as I can. I've seen every final.
Which is quite a lot this year.
It is every final since we first started.
Fantastic support for both teams here in Belfast. Anyway, Ayr almost brought the scores back level at the start of the third period through Scott Young and Mike Harding. But O'Neill in the Steelers' goal was also having a big night, making the double save to frustrate the Eagles again. And take a look at this statistic from the first two periods. The Steelers still outshooting the Eagles by over 2-1.
Definitely a game worthy of a final, this one. It's been dramatic stuff. Eagles setting it up at the point, driven in, bounces. That's Bauba. Bauba takes it off the bar. Oh, Bauba rings it off the bar. And that was the Eagles' opportunity to get dead level as the Steelers now bring it the other direction. That's Rick Brabant dropping it off. The Steelers trying to generate something. Intercepted, might bounce kindly for them here. Rick Brabant, good work on the floor to keep the Eagles in that corner and force Doyle backwards.
Well, I don't think the Air Scottish Eagles are going to get a better chance than that in the game. Bauba, you would have put your mortgage on him to score from there. And he just fired upstairs. He just went a little too high. And I'll tell you what, a quarter of the inch of the way, it's a goal.
That was Byram's pass there. He was looking to set Eberle free. Didn't quite work out for him. The defenceman couldn't quite get on it. We see Jonathan Weaver on the ice, despite his injury there, trying to make things happen for the Eagles. Still a goal down in this one. McCosh from defence for the Steelers. They're laying a hand on the Challenge Cup now. Longstaff brings it into the zone. Longstaff just drops it off for Beraldo, takes a kick into the corner. Brabant will be there for the Steelers. Brabant holds his man off and gets it out in front. Turned away again. Rick Brabant bounces it off that corner. That's Longstaff to feed it out for Beraldo. Brabant upstairs and scores! Rick Brabant with the crucial goal for the Sheffield Steelers. That can be oh so important because it keeps momentum on their side despite all that Eagles pressure, and Brabant taking advantage of a lucky bounce which brought him the puck.
Bitter disappointment for the Air Scottish Eagles, but the Steelers come back. Great feed from Longstaff, and there's Brabant Oh, top corner, you see the water bottle jumping, and that's a great sight for Rick Brabant and the Sheffield Steelers fans. Here's another chance, right over the puck goes Paul Baraldo. There is Rick Brabant to fire this one. Maybe it's going to be his 18th title since he's come over here to Britain.
Well, Philippe de Rouville couldn't have done any more, really. It took a deflection as it came across him, then Paul Baraldo just sort of skipped over it and let it run to Brabant, and by the time de Rouville realised where it was far too late.
An absolutely desperate minute of play for the Air Scottish Eagles. So close to scoring at one end with this shot from Bauber rebounding off the bar and then falling further behind through Brabant.
Rick Brabant skates forward to take the face-off for the Sheffield Steelers inside Air Scottish Eagles territory, and he wins it as well. Gets it back to Short. Short drives the shot in early. That's gone well wide, though. And the Eagles will try and clear their line swiftly. They do. They force it forward, and around the boards it goes on the feed-in from Harding. Steelers there first with Longstaff. And now they should clear it. Under pressure all the time now. The Eagles keeping the pressure on as Brabant passes it to Longstaff. Longstaff throw on net. De Rouville out, smothers it, kicks it away. This is Brabant, takes it on the backhand. Oh, turned off the line. The defenseman there, I think it was Hillstrom, turning it away.
Two fantastic chances, and the Sheffield Steelers had the chance to put this game to bed, but Philippe de Rouville and then Hillstrom managed to kick that one off the line. And the Air Scottish Eagles, well, there's still life in them, and let's see if that swung momentum the other way.
And Bauber drives it in from distance and takes the deflection, goes over the plexi and brings a moment of relief.
And a moment perhaps for us to have a look back at just what happened and the chances for the Sheffield Steelers. Here we're going to see David Longstaff. He fires the first one in. That's really kicked away well by de Rouville, coming out challenging the shooter. Second chance. Here comes to Brabant, and there's Hillstrom right on the line. He just takes that on his arms. That must have hurt him. But he's right in the right place at the right time.
Face-off is back at the other end, though. Craigwell to contest this one now for the Sheffield Steelers. This time it's the Eagles who come up with it. Young clearing it away, forcing it forward. Held in by the Sheffield Steelers, and finally Hare get rid of it into neutral ice, and Smith can drive it back in. Young will be there ahead of Craigwell, who shadows him all the way as Young flips it around. Steelers still holding it in the zone. Good work there. They've given it up now, though. Here's Wynn on the red line. Wynn flips it over the top, chases on for the Air Scottish Eagles, and McCosh has to ride the check. Steelers flipping it forward now, left-hand side. Craigwell tried to feed it inside to find Simpson. It's gone all the way across now. And here comes McCosh jumping forward from defence, feeding inside for Simpson, who drives it. Kicked away by de Rouville and cleared away from in front of him as well. And the Eagles ride their luck just a little bit again.
As the Air Scottish Eagles, they've got to keep pushing forward now. This is their opportunity to try and win a trophy this year. And they have to go forward, and the Steelers are just trying to capitalise on the breakout. And there was Simpson breaking with speed, but de Rouville again had a good game this evening.
So much confidence in the Sheffield Steelers camp at the moment. Two trophies already under their belt. Two more to go. This is one of them. Harding with a check on Smith there. But the Steelers come up with the puck, and that's the crucial thing for them at the moment, is possession, as they go down that right-hand side with Brabant, who tried to find Longstaff. Longstaff reaching for the puck. Good work from him to feed it towards Baraldo. Courtney's there first for the Air Scottish Eagles. Up against the boards inside his own zone. Baraldo tried to hold it in. It pops out for Rick Brabant. In that corner, Rick Brabant trying to dig it out, gets it back towards the blue line now. Steelers still holding it in the zone. Courtney wrestles it out of that corner, and still they can't clear it, the Air Scottish Eagles. That's Harding who's gone down. I think he took the puck in the face there as they tried to flip it in.
Oof. Well, a little backhand flip, and it got Harding right in the side of the face. I think it's going to be harsh to say this right now, as you see blood dripping from him, that he's actually got a little bit lucky. I think the puck hit him flat as opposed to on edge. If it would have hit him on edge, it could have done some real damage to the bone structure of the face.
Well, we'll see it again here. It is just a little flip upstairs, at least, rather than a driven shot.
But you've got to remember, that's frozen vulcanized rubber. It's like a rubber bullet hitting you in the face.
Harding rushed off to hospital for stitches and for treatment on a suspected fractured cheekbone. Once play had restarted, Steelers goalie Mike O'Neill continued to frustrate the Eagles as they pile on the pressure. And with the clock ticking down, Sheffield captain Dennis Vial was again sin-binned on a slashing call. The Eagles with a one-man advantage as we return to the action.
Well, that fan is hoping things stay as they are. 4-2 to the Sheffield Steelers. And time ticking down for the Air Scottish Eagles to do something about it. Once again, the Steelers clear their own zone. And on this power play, this is the Eagles' last best hope, really.
The Eagles have to score on this power play. If they do want to get back into this game, this is going to be the best opportunity they're going to have.
Here they go now then, carrying it into the zone. Bristow's driving towards the far post, looking for the pass now, just kicked away from him. And the Steelers should be able to get this rid of this, and they can. Nice work from Carpenter, carries it over the blue line, pushes it into that far corner.
Steelers doing another good job of penalty killing, and they've done that all night long, to be fair to them. The Air Scottish Eagles, really a side of Tony Han, haven't looked that dangerous on the power play.
Only one power play for the Sheffield Steelers, considerably more than that for the Air Scottish Eagles. They've had six so far and capitalised on one. Tony Han circling inside his own zone. He's the man who scored that power play goal that they've intercepted. And away goes Kent Simpson. Kent Simpson throw on net, just turned away from him. I think maybe his stick lifted a bit there as he went through.
Well, I think he was waiting for Christmas, wasn't he? That was the only thing that stopped him from shooting. His stick was just cocked, and for one reason or another, he just wouldn't bring it back down.
It is driven in again from Sebastian and just goes wide. And the Steelers, at the moment, are putting the pressure on, but away come the Eagles now. Pushing it forward, Mike Blaisdell is going to enjoy seeing this because the Steelers are really making air work for every ounce of possession as they carry it into that corner again.
And Paul Heavey, the coach of the Air Scottish Eagles, is going to be frustrated. He's going to be standing on that bench telling the Eagles just to get that puck forward as quickly as they can.
And here comes Jonathan Weaver now. Jonathan Weaver playing through injury, gets it inside, and O'Neill is across again.
And how much of the Air Scottish Eagles miss Jonathan Weaver? He's playing with that bruised sternum. He's not really had the opportunity to get out there. And he's been such an influence for them all season long as he uses his speed on Adam Smith. And he just slows Smith down here. He makes a little move, goes all the way around the outside, but he's kept his head up. Sees Ed Courtney driving in. And it's that deflection there from Jeff Sebastian. Took it right away from Courtney. Otherwise, you're looking Courtney from a few feet out. And then we see Kent Simpson at the other end. Look at him. Picks his stick up. Oh, he just got it actually hooked away from him and ended up just riding into Deruva.
Well, if there was only this long to go in football, you'd say it was all over, but ice hockey's different, sir.
Yeah, 1:31 remaining, and the Air Scottish Eagles, they have to score quickly. They need to get the offensive zone draw one, and then they need to get the shot on net and get a goal in the first 10, 15 seconds, and then see if they can get back down the end of the ice and see if they can get another one.
How crucial are those timeouts?
Oh, really crucial, because it gives the best players a little bit of a chance to have a break and rest up, and it also gives Paul Heavey the chance to plan a play and to try and decide exactly who's going to shoot the puck and make sure that all the players are on the same page.
Well, coach Paul Heavey has chosen to pull netminder Philip Deruville. Six out skaters now for the Air Scottish Eagles, but an empty net away to our right as the Steelers win that face-off and flip it straight down into Eagles territory.
That was how important the face-off was. Ed Courtney waiting on the point. He's now got the puck, but he didn't get the chance to shoot it early.
And Eagles have to get straight back at them quickly. They drive it into that corner now, trying to hold it into the zone. Gordon flipping around behind that. Comes out in front, driven in by Han, and just turned away. Flips out towards that right-hand side, as you would expect with the extra man. Eagles have the opportunity to get it back in the corner. That's Courtney. Courtney looking for the pass, puts it in down low. Clock ticking down all the time for the Air Scottish Eagles. They need two goals. Gordon flips it in on net, takes a rebound out in front. He'll come back towards the blue line. Flipped out towards the right side, driven in again, just goes wide. Craigwell can mop up, flips it out towards the right, under pressure all the time, the Sheffield Steelers, but they've managed to put it out into Eagles territory and give themselves just a break from all that pressure.
They've given themselves a break, but because it's an icing call, the shot went in on the empty net. It went behind the goal line, the defenseman touched up, so the face-off goes all the way back down to the other end of the ice. And Tony Han, he had the best opportunity, fired this one in, just deflected wide by the defenseman. But what a game he's had so far. And Paul Heavey, he's just trying to direct his troops on the bench. But Sean Byram, the centreman for the Air Scottish Eagles, he should win this.
And he has won it, gets it out. Courtney wrists it in, cake to bounce. Gordon tries to drive it in. O'Neill's there at his far post just to kick that one away. It's bouncing all over the shop at the moment as the Eagles finally put sticks on it. They're trying to force it out towards Scott Young on the right-hand side, but the Steelers have picked it up. The empty net is waiting for them. They push it down the right-hand side, and it's Weaver against Young. Young will have an outlet over on this left-hand side, but the clock is getting dangerously close to zero for the Air Scottish Eagles. Ignore the confetti. It's not over yet, but that whistle might mean it is, because it's going to bring it out to neutralise the offside.
Well, the Air Scottish Eagles have thrown everything they could possibly throw at the Sheffield Steelers. And although Mike Blaisdell on the bench still looks a little bit worried, it's going to be these fans that are going home happy at the end of this evening.
It's been a great final, hasn't it?
Worthy, really worthy final. two teams that have come out and they've just played hockey. No silliness, they've just come out and we've seen some really great goals. That goal from Warren Norris, and also the performance of Tony Hamm. He's shown just what a class act
he is. Chance on the empty net now, it just goes wide from the Sheffield Steelers. They nearly put the cap on it there. Young picks it up, just loses the puck behind him. He's still skating away. It's not going to matter, because there goes the hooter, and the Sheffield Steelers have the Challenge Cup won for the third year running. They love this competition. They love winning it. The players have put the off-ice problems behind it to seal it with another great team performance.
It is. I actually tipped Belfast to win the Challenge Cup. How wrong was I? And I'm sure I'm going to hear about that for the rest of this season. But the Sheffield Steelers have come out, and when the chips have been down, they've come and they've performed on the ice. And what a performance it's been in the final. And the Air Scottish Eagles, on the other hand, they've played ever so well as well. And Tony Hand's had a fantastic performance this evening, showed just why he's one of the greats. And that man, Warren Norris, was absolutely inspirational for the Steelers in the first period.
Great night for hockey in every way. Great night for the fans. Great night for the Sheffield Steelers.
You've got to feel sorry for the Eagles. They gave it their all. Let's have a quick chat with the Sheffield fans. You must be absolutely delighted.
Tremendous. Three cup finals so far, three victories this season, one more to go. Hey! Yes! Hey! Oh! Yeah! Hold it, champion! Hold it! Champion! Champion!
So great scenes at the end of the match. The Steelers fans getting used to this. Sheffield winning the Challenge Cup by 4-2. And captain Dennis Vial lifted the team's third trophy of the season. Just the playoff title to go on their quest for the Grand Slam.
Now you must be delighted with your boys tonight.
Yeah, they played their asses off again. They've never let me down once on the ice, ever.
And what do you think was the turning point of the match for you?
I think when we scored, they scored a goal. It was just allowed, and then we scored. And I think that was a big goal for us. It caught them off balance. But I think our penalty killing was superb. We had to kill, I think, 7 or 8 minor penalties in a row. So we only had one power play all night. They had about 8 or 9, I think. So it was difficult for them.
And a word about Air. They had a good game, really.
They had a great game. They played with heart and desire. They kept coming and coming and coming, and so we never had an easy shift. And they played their best game all year against us, I thought.
It's tough to say. I didn't quite see it. Obviously, Tony put the puck in the net, but just as that happened, Eddie Courtney was in the crease there. I'm not sure whether Eddie was in there before the puck went in, how he got into the crease, to be honest. But it was a big turning point. They scored very soon after that, and it was a big change in momentum. And in the third period, Dino Bauba hit the crossbar. A great opportunity to hit the crossbar. Puck bounced out and even up the other end and scored. So it was a big, big swing in momentum. There were key moments. I mean, if we had scored, it's kind of we going to the leader. If Dino had scored, it's a tight hockey game. And it didn't quite go for us.
The final shots then of this season's Challenge Cup winners, the Sheffield Steelers, arguably, and it is arguably, the best team ever assembled in the British game. A fitting venue for the series to end as well, because this season, Belfast Odyssey Arena has emerged as one of the best sports venues in the whole of the UK. So, Sheffield Steelers have been crowned champions of the Challenge Cup, proving why ice hockey is Britain's favourite indoor sport. We hope you've enjoyed yourself here on 4 Later. It's been an absolutely thrilling tournament. See you again.